Hi, I'm Ben from Freemius. Imagine this situation. You arrive home after a hard day's work and you ask yourself, what should I eat for dinner? On one hand, I can cook something that will be cheap, but will probably take some time to prepare. And on the other hand, I can order something that will probably be more expensive, but ready to eat in no time without the whole cooking hassle. But that creates a problem with my bank account. As WordPress plugin developers, we are faced with many different options on how to sell our plugins, with some options benefiting our bank accounts and some options hurting them. Many of us rely on marketplaces like CodeCanyon as the most common and easiest solution available. But will selling through CodeCanyon help you create a significant flow of income? Is that really the best way to create a long-lasting, sustainable business? In this video, I'll go through the pros and cons of selling on CodeCanyon and show you that selling your plugins on this marketplace is definitely not the only way to go. Let's plug in! Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for future videos. If you're watching this directly on YouTube, you can click the alert icon for notifications about new releases. CodeCanyon is a well-known plugins marketplace that handles selling and distribution, and their platform has a huge base of buyers and sellers. Many developers use CodeCanyon to sell their plugins. Some of them even have a seven-figure business running through it. Is it possible to sell successfully outside of CodeCanyon? The answer is most definitely yes. Before talking about alternatives, let's examine some of the benefits of using CodeCanyon. I know developers who have thriving businesses selling through CodeCanyon. After all, we as developers usually enjoy building cool products. That's what we're good at, not selling them. Many of us don't like the hassle of marketing and selling our plugins. And if CodeCanyon takes that burden off our backs, why not pay a price for it? It's a great perk. Another benefit of listing your plugin on their marketplace is that they have a solid review process, so you get some professional feedback when you start selling your plugins through it. The bad news is that the price you pay to sell your plugin through CodeCanyon can be very high, not only in terms of the commission you pay for their services, but also in other ways that will definitely eliminate the chance of your business becoming a sustainable form of income that you can actually make a living from. Don't forget that because CodeCanyon is a very popular marketplace, competition is fierce. As of the filming of this video, there are more than 7,100 WordPress plugins for sale on CodeCanyon. In addition to that, customers tend to go with the most popular plugins that are typically listed before others on the search result page. With this approach to search results, popular plugins stay popular, and new plugins like yours, which are as good as the popular ones, are easily ignored. As a beginner seller, you won't have any other choice but to market and promote your plugins in addition to listing them on CodeCanyon, in order to get some traffic. This contradicts the whole premise of a marketplace, which is supposed to completely take care of the marketing of your products. This brutal competition drives a race to the bottom, making many developers lower their prices significantly. This kind of race makes sense, since CodeCanyon serves developers from all over the world, so the cost of living can be very different from one developer to another. Developers that need less money for their living won't have much problem lowering prices. The same thing goes for customers as well. Why should they buy your plugin if they can find a similar plugin for a cheaper price in a click of a button? How can you make your brand stand out in this ocean of products? A common technique is lowering your prices to attract more attention. Even if you try this strategy and you start driving more sales, due to the pricing structure of CodeCanyon, the lower your price goes, the higher the percentage commission you pay. For example, if you are a new seller and you decide to sell your plugin for $30, you are left with less than half of it, even before paying any taxes. Every WordPress plugin developer should ask themselves if that is a price they are willing to pay. Not only that, but CodeCanyon has a very strict exclusivity policy that will milk even more commission out of you if you sell your plugin elsewhere. This means that $30 will become only $9.50. If you lower your plugin's price to $10, it will leave you with a whole 50 cents. That's 95% commission. I can't really imagine how it's possible to build a sustainable business this way. Another thing that makes CodeCanyon so limiting is the fact that there are no automatically renewing subscriptions. Buyers pay once for downloading your premium plugin, get 6 months of support, and a lifetime of updates. Customers have the option to extend their support package, but in reality, most of them don't. After a year or so, you end up with a base of customers that stop paying, but they're still eligible for ongoing updates, which kind of forces you to keep supporting them forever, whether you like it or not. Let's say that you released an update for your plugin with a bug that broke a few customers' sites, which happens to all of us at some point. What if you have a user who bought your plugin 3 years ago and the new update destroyed their site? Think of the damage to your brand if you refuse to fix that issue for free. A great way to promote your plugin is through affiliate marketing, which does exist on CodeCanyon, but again, in a very limited form. The affiliate program's terms are not attractive, but you have no choice other than to comply with them. That means your chances of getting professional affiliates to promote your plugins are very slim. The list of limitations when using CodeCanyon to sell plugins just goes on and on. You don't have a direct connection with your customers. You don't even know who they are, and you can't contact them in case you decide to move away from CodeCanyon. You also can't create any promotion sales or coupons for special occasions like Black Friday, for example, which really limits you on the marketing side. Do you think you'll be able to create a sustainable business that can thrive within the rigid limitations set by CodeCanyon? It is definitely not easy to choose the right path for your business. I think that the best starting point for deciding is to ask yourself, what's the stage of my plugin business? Am I just starting? Do I already have some plugins on the market? Is my business well established? Do I want to try using a different business model to grow my sales? If you are just starting your business and want to sell premium-only plugins, CodeCanyon might be a good option for you. It is a great platform to test the waters and see if there is a market for your plugin. Getting feedback from CodeCanyon's review team and attention from customers might give you the confidence you need to move forward. It's relatively easy, it's fast, and it might be harder to open and maintain your own online store. But remember, every business has an opportunity to grow and become more successful by its own right. I'm here to show you that there are other options if you don't want to limit yourself to marketplaces like CodeCanyon in the long term. There are several great monetization services that you can use to sell your plugins, including Freemius. These services will allow you to focus on building awesome WordPress plugins while handling all the e-commerce aspects of the payments, licensing, subscriptions, EU VAT, and more. This creates total freedom for you in controlling the pricing and licensing of your plugin, and new users are introduced to your brand with full transparency of all your offerings. You still have to find an alternative distribution channel for CodeCanyon. You can explore common marketing practices like SEO and paid ads, which obviously comes with a learning curve. Or an easier approach, just create a free version of your plugin and submit it to the WordPress.org plugin repository. This will expose your product to at least 5 times more potential customers than CodeCanyon, and it will help you generate that initial traction without investing too much into marketing. After you've done that, you can promote the paid version within the WordPress dashboard settings of your free plugin, and if you end up choosing Freemius, you can even let users upgrade to your premium version directly from the WordPress dashboard. Creating great plugins is only the first step of the way, but by using the right strategy for selling your plugins, you can secure your success and make your business a lot more sustainable, so that you'll be able to make a living out of it for many years. My advice to you is, don't always go for the quickest or easiest solution. Using a service that puts your business benefit in front and enables you total freedom can be the right way to thrive and grow. Remember, ordering takeout for dinner is easy, but in the long run, it will not sustain your bank account. If you like this video and want to stay up to date with the best practices for selling WordPress plugins, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to the Freemius blog on freemius.com. See you next time!